Good morning, students. I am Mayank Tiwari. Today we will solve one paper, Assistant Agriculture Officer by RPSC Ajmer. It contains lot of questions for general agriculture which can be asked in your BHU and Pannagar exam. Let's start. Student, first question you see, on volume basis, a sample of pure air on the average consists of -% carbon dioxide. It is asking the concentration of carbon dioxide by volume in a sample of fresh air. So some of the important details I am telling you, remember them. First, nitrogen. Nitrogen percent by volume is 78%. Oxygen percentage by volume is 20.95%. They sometimes ask about argon. Argon percentage by volume is 0.93%. Carbon dioxide is 0.03%. And the present concentration of carbon dioxide in atmosphere is about 412 ppm. Remember it. And the carbon dioxide concentration is monitored from an observatory. It is an observatory in Hawaii Island called Mauna Loa. Mauna Loa Observatory monitors the global concentration of carbon dioxide. Remember them. Student, now some basic fact about climatology and climate which can be important for your general agriculture perspective. The book I am using is Dhimra Sunda. You can read from these also. And atmosphere is a colorless, tasteless and odorless mixture of gases that surround the earth. Height of atmosphere 1600 km. This fact you remember, 99% of the total mass of atmosphere is within 40 km of the earth. Structure of atmosphere, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere and thermosphere. Height of troposphere 8 to 18 km and temperature decreases as we go up in the troposphere. This is called lapse rate. The normal lapse rate is 6.5 degrees centigrade per kilometer. Remember it. And troposphere is also called theater of weather phenomena. All the weather phenomena, cloud, rainfall, etc. They all take place in troposphere. Then student, stratosphere. Stratosphere is 8 to 18 km. Remember it. It is the warmest layer. And presence of ozone layer in a stratosphere, that is also called ozonosphere. And actual seat for most of the photochemical reaction in air is stratosphere. Remember it, student. This line is very important. I am repeating. Stratosphere is the actual seat of most of the photochemical reaction in the air. Then student, mesosphere 18 to 50 km. And student, remember the height. 8 to 18 km is your troposphere. From 18 to 50 km is your stratosphere. From 50 to 85 km it is your mesosphere. Remember it. And mesosphere is cold region. And student, thermosphere. Thermosphere is the outermost layer. And it extends up to a height of 80 km to 1600 km. The lowest layer of thermosphere is called ionosphere. And this fact, student, most important. Long distance radio communication is made through ionized layer of thermosphere. Remember it. Now student, these ISO questions can be asked in your exams. Contours, line joining equal elevation, line joining uniform value of any phenomena is called isoplet. Imaginary line connecting point of equal atmospheric pressure is isobar. Equal amount of rainfall is isohight. Equal water table elevation is isobath. Equal sunshine hour is isohel. Line joining point of similar seasonal phenomena is called isophene. Equal temperature, isotherm. Equal number of neutron, isotone. Student, this isotone was asked in JRF Physical Science paper 2018. So these ISO terms are very important. Some more ISO term I am telling you, remember them. And student, this equal depth of rainfall is isopluvial. Equal wind velocity, this is also important. Isotech, equal moisture content, isostere. Similar disease severity, isodemic. And least cost combination of input, for all input it is isocline, remember them. Now student, some more important facts which are relevant for your competitive exam. Solar constant. What is solar constant? Energy falling in 1 minute on a surface area of 1 square centimeter at outer boundary of atmosphere held normal to light at the mean distance of earth from the sun. What is the mean distance of earth from the sun? 150 million kilometer. So either they can give you definition and what is solar constant they can ask, and they can ask the numerical value of solar constant. So numerical value of solar constant is 1.94 calorie per centimeter square per minute, or SI unit is 1353 watt per meter square. Student, this is the most important question, has been asked repeatedly. What is the value of solar constant? What is the unit of solar constant? What is the value of solar constant in watt per meter square? Remember it. 1.94 calorie per centimeter square per minute, or 1353 watt per meter square. The solar radiation is received in form of electromagnetic particle called quanta or photon. photosynthetically active radiation. Wavelength also remember 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer. And what? How do we measure photosynthetically active radiation? Quantum sensor. What is the unit of photosynthetically active radiation? Einstein or watt per meter square. And what is the oldest unit to measure intensity of solar radiation? It is lux. A spectrometer measure solar radiation in narrow waveband. Now student, come to question number 2. In addition to nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide, the other principal gas present in the atmosphere. So student, it is argon. I told you just now. Student, question number 3, you see, the atmosphere notionally divided into 4 layers on the basis of vertical. So student, this classification, troposphere, thermosphere, ionosphere and mesosphere, this is on the basis of temperature differences. Remember that. And student, question number 4, you see, the lowest layer of atmosphere is called, I just now told you, first is troposphere, the lowermost layer, 8 to 18 kilometer, then from 18 to 50 kilometer is your stratosphere, then from 50 to 85 kilometer is your mesosphere, and from 85 to 1600 kilometer is your thermosphere or ionosphere. Student, question number 5 can also be important. 1 bar pressure is equal to how much dyne per centimeter square? Student, this question is very important. 1 bar pressure is equal to 10 to the power 6 dyne per centimeter square. Student, question number 6, you see, altitude of a place is height of that place above mean sea level. Option number D is important. Option number D is correct. Altitude of a place is height of that place above the mean sea level. Student, question number 7, you see, most common place in a city where value of altitude for that city is mentioned. So student, the altitude of a city is mentioned in the railway station. Remember it. Student, question number 8, you see, 1 angstrom is equal to. Student, again a very basic and fundamental question. He is asking the value of angstrom in meters. So 1 angstrom is equal to 10 raised to, you can give the answer in centimeter also, because the correct answer is in centimeter. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 8 centimeter. Student, question number 9, you see, atmospheric phenomena like fog and dew require a minimum of dash percentage relative humidity. Student, this question is very important. Atmospheric phenomena like fog and dew require a minimum of what percentage of relative humidity, it is asking you. So remember it. Atmospheric phenomena, fog and dew require minimum 75% relative humidity. Option number C is correct. Student, question number 10, you see, sowing can safeguard the crop against temporary flooding due to heavy rains. See what is asking in this question. There are heavy rains and due to which there is temporary flooding. So how you are going to sow your crop so that they are protected? So in case of temporary flooding due to heavy rains, ridge sowing is done. Option number C is correct. Student, question number 11, you see, smoking by burning safeguard crop against. So smoking by burning wood safeguard the crop against frost. Remember it. Student, again very basic question. The term agriculture is derived from, agriculture is a Latin word and agronomy is a Greek word. If you read the first line of Arun Katyan, it is given there. Student, question number 14, you see, who is known as father of tillage? So Jethro Tull is known as father of tillage. Tillage is a Anglo-Saxon word. Remember it. And amla is a rich source of vitamin C. Everybody knows. Student, regarding tillage, I am telling you some important questions. The book I am using is Indian Society of Soil Science. So tillage, sometime they ask you, what is the single most effective component of crop production? Tillage. Tillage involves shearing, compressive and tensile strength. Student, there is a statement, good tilth brings seeds, ill tillers weed. This statement is given by Freem. What it means that if you are doing your tillage good, then your seed will be good. Otherwise, if you are doing faulty tillage practices, lot of weeds will generate in your field. So good tilth brings seed, ill tillers weed. This statement is given by Freem. Thus, the term zero tillage is given by Jethro Tull. Remember it. But student, father of zero tillage is JBS Triplett. Remember it. But the term zero tillage is given by Jethro Tull. Remember it. What is primary tillage, student? Break soil surface into clot. This is known as primary tillage. What is secondary tillage? To pulverize, repack and smooth the soil surface. This is known as secondary tillage. There is a book very famous, Book of Husbandry. This famous book, Book of Husbandry, is written by Fisher Bird. What is the PF value for puddling? 0.5 to 2.8. Student, this question has been asked many times. What is the PF value for puddling? 0.5 to 2.8. Puddling is done in plastic consistency. Remember it. There is another one famous book. Remember the name? Plowman Folly. Plowman Folly book is written by Faulkner. And Book of Husbandry is written by Fisher Bird. Remember it. And chemical foundation of new tillage farming is Paracot. Primary tillage is divided into... Sorry, student. Tillage is divided into two types. Conventional tillage and conservation tillage. Conventional tillage has two types. Primary tillage and secondary tillage. And secondary is your conservation tillage. And in case of conservation tillage, 30% of the soil surface is covered by plant residue. Remember, student, this is a very important question. In conservation tillage, how much percentage of soil surface is covered by plant residue? 30%. And student, conservation tillage has four types: no tillage, reduced tillage, stubble mulch tillage, or rich tillage. Remember it. Student, one more fact to remember, that ploughing, puddling, and cage wheel, they come under the category of primary tillage. And sometime they ask you septometer. What is septometer used for? Septometer is used for measuring the leaf area index. Remember it. Now student, this figure can be important for you. In intensive tillage, less than 15% residue retention. In reduced tillage, 15 to 30% residue retention. In conservation tillage, 30 to 50% residue retention. And in zero tillage, more than 50% residue retention. Remember it. And one more figure I am giving you at the last. Higher percentage of larger aggregate, greater than 5 mm are required for irrigated agriculture. And higher percentage of smaller aggregate, 1 to 2 mm are desirable for dryland agriculture. Remember it. Now student, at the last, some important figures I am giving you, remember them. Earth has only 2.7% of fresh water. Remember it. Earth has only 2.7% of fresh water resources, out of which only 30% of fresh water resources are available to us. And 4% of the total fresh water resources in the world are present in India. Remember it. I am repeating. 4% of the total water resources in the world are present in India. India has 2.3% of world geographical area. If the water level goes below 1700 meter cube, it is stress level. And in 2025, the water per capita water availability in India will be less than 1500 meter cube. And India annual rainfall is 400 million hectare meter. Remember it. India has 400 million hectare meter annual rainfall. And India has 4% of precipitation globally. One fact to remember, 1 million hectare meter is equal to 10 kilometer cube. So student, these all facts to remember. That's all for today. Thank you.